So before going to that, we have to know what is the IC bus. So IC is integrated circuit. So definition of the IC is, IC is miniature low cost electronic circuit consisting of all active as well as passive components are irreparably joined together in a single chip of a circuit. So that is a simple definition of a IC. So these ICs are classified into different types depending on the application. Those are linear ICs and digital ICs. So linear means analog, so those are the analog ICs, and we have a digital ICs also. So digital ICs we are using for digital applications, analog ICs are applicable for analog applications. Like one of the most applicable IC we are using for the analog applications are 741, IC 741. So this IC we have for mostly linear applications like amplifiers and filters, waveform generators, oscillators, and we are using mostly in a comparator. So this IC, we have 741 IC, can be used in a open loop mode and closed loop mode. So only one application we have in a open loop mode as a comparator. So one of the only one application we have for the op-amp when it is in a open loop mode. So when op-amp is in open loop mode, means we are not giving any feedback. So in that case, the output will be saturated. So the output should be a maximum. Why? Because this op-amp has high gain. So it has a high input impedance and a high input gain. So because of that, if a small voltage, if the op-amp is in the open loop mode, so then if you are applying a small input voltage also, it generates a maximum output. So why? Because input impedance and gain of the op-amp is a high. So without giving any input case also, but a small value, if you have any noise value at the input, that has to be amplified more and we are getting the maximum gain. So maximum in the sense it will be saturating well. So output will be saturated. So because of that, the op-amp will be used in a open loop mode for only one application, that is a comparator circuit. But in a closed loop, the gain will be reduced. So because of that, that will be used for the many other applications like oscillator, waveforms, filters, those all. So only one application we have, that is a comparator. So comparator, what is a comparator is, so op-amp is used in a open loop mode. So op-amp has a 5 main terminals, right? So op-amp has 5 main terminals. What are the 5 main terminals? Has inverting input, non-inverting input, and plus VSAT, that means plus supply, and negative power supply, and output. So negative input, that is the inverting input we are calling, and positive input is called non-inverting input. So for the op-amp we have these 5 main input terminals. So we are not giving any feedback. What is the feedback? Is the some part of the output we have to given as an input, then that is called a feedback. So here we are using the open loop mode, so there is no feedback, right? So we have an inverting input and non-inverting input. Depending on the applied input, these comparators are classified into two types. Right? So what is a comparator is? Comparator is a circuit, the name itself it is saying, it is used to compare the one fixed voltage with a given input voltage. Any voltage can be applied as a fixed voltage and other will be a variable one. So that will be compared. So one of the input voltage will be comparing with the other value, fixed value. So that comparator will be classified into two types based on the applied input. Based on applied input to the terminal, to the negative or a positive terminal, these comparators are classified into two types. So first one is the inverting comparator, and second one is the non-inverting comparator. So what is the inverting comparator is, here we have two inputs, right? So one is a positive input and one is the negative input, right? So inverting comparator means the input voltage we have to apply to the inverting terminal. So negative is the inverting terminal. So we have to apply the input to the negative terminal and fixed reference value that has to be compared. Some fixed reference value will be applied to the positive terminal. So then the type of the comparator is called a inverting comparator. Right? Similarly, if suppose I have a non-inverting comparator. So non-inverting comparator is exactly reverse. So that means we have to apply the input to the non-inverting comparator. Means here we have a negative and positive. Input will be given to the non-inverting terminal and fixed V reference value will be connected to the negative terminal. Then that type of a comparator is a non-inverting comparator. So the input will be given to the positive terminal, then that is called a non-inverting comparator. And if input is given to the inverting terminal, then that is called a inverting comparator, right? So those are the two types of a comparator. So first we will go to the any one of the comparator. So just what we have, so the comparator having two inputs, so we have to draw. So first we go to the this one basic inverting comparator, first one. So now this is inverting, right? This is inverting. Why? Because we are applying the input to the negative terminal. So before going to the working of this, we have to know the op-amp characteristics. That so for the op-amp, open loop mode, negative and positive terminal we are applying. So open loop gain will be infinite. So output will be saturated. I already told, if it is in a open loop mode, op-amp will be in a open loop mode. When op-amp is in open loop mode, in voltage gain, so that should be voltage gain should be infinite. So output will be always saturated. So output will be in saturated level. So what is the saturated level? You have to know. So that saturating level of voltage will be changes depending on the supply value. So how much the supply we are applying here, plus VCC and minus VCC. Two power supplies we are applying for the op amp. So positive power supply and negative power supply. So if suppose, for example, that power supply should be a minimum of plus or minus 5 volts, should be plus or minus 15 volts, we can be applied for the op amp. So for example, here I am taking, for example, if suppose DCC supply voltage, I applied as a plus 12 volts. So how much here that we are getting a desaturated value is 90% of that. So approximately, we will get a desat value will be 11 volts. Approximately, 11 volts. Plus or minus 11 volts. So here it will be a plus VSAT in the sense 11 volts positive and minus VSAT in the sense minus 11 volts. Like that, that output voltage will be changes depending on the power supply voltage. If the supply voltage is 12, 90% of it 12, it will be generated as a saturated value. Similarly, if you change the 15, so that will be approximately 13.6 like that. So that's a working we have to know. And what is that saturated level of voltage will be, you know. So now coming to this, for the op amp, if negative terminal is more potential, if positive terminal we are applying the voltage, similarly negative terminal also we are applying the voltage. If negative terminal potential is higher than the positive terminal potential, so that means we are applying the higher positive voltage than the negative positive terminal. So because of that case, what will your output is? Here negative terminal is high. So negative terminal is high means output will be a minus V side. Output should be a minus V side. Similarly, if the case, the reversal case, if negative terminal potential is low than the positive potential, positive terminal potential, then your output should be a plus V side. So this is the only one important point you have to remember for understanding the working of a comparator, right? So if positive terminal potential is greater, output will be a plus V side. If negative terminal potential is greater, output should be a minus V side. And this plus V side and minus V side will be depending on your power supply voltage, right? So that we have to know. So now coming to this working operation of this. So what we have to apply? Here we are applying the input. So for example, here I am applying the input as a sinusoidal signal. For example, from the function generator, I am applying the input here plus V. So some sinusoidal signal I am applying as a input. Here not only the sign, any type of a signal can be applied as a input. That input signal will be comparing with the fixed reference of, here I am taking a positive reference, fixed reference value, and that will be generates the output. So here we are getting the output. How it will be works, we have to know. So here already you know negative terminal and positive terminal voltages we have. So V reference is comparing. Here input signal is comparing with the V reference. So how many cases we have? Two cases. V in is greater than V reference or V in is less than V reference. So we have two cases here. First case, what happens here? If suppose, if V in is greater than the V reference, we are applying the two voltages, V input and V reference. If V in is greater than the V reference, what is your output voltage? So V naught is equal to, V in is greater, right? So V in, where we are at? Negative term. So V in is greater, so that means this is high and this is low, right? So what is your output should be in a plus V side. V in is, sorry, negative terminal is greater. So negative terminal is greater in the sense, output will be a minus V side. Similarly, second case, if V in is lesser than the V reference. If V in is lesser than the V reference, now simply it will be opposite, right? So V in is smaller. So V in is low and V difference is 5. So now what is your output? Positive terminal is greater, so your output should be changes to plus V sat. So like this, your output will be changes to plus V sat or minus V sat depending on your applied input and V reference value. So for the comparator, fixed reference value we have to apply and continuous analog signal of your sinusoidal output. So if you observe the output waveform, for example here, I am taking a sinusoidal wave, right? So this is my sinusoidal input signal. For example here, this is a time axis and this is your input. Okay, so input having the sinusoidal signal I applied and V reference is a positive V reference, right? So here I am taking some V reference value, this is my positive V reference, so this is your V reference value, right? So here this is the point that will be a comparing your V reference with the V input. So what is your output we have to observe? So this is your output signal now, so output waveform with respective of time axis. So here below this will be a 0 and this is your V reference. This is a lower the line, whatever you have difference value, below value, right? So these all are the lesser values. These all are the V reference smaller value. V in is greater and V reference is smaller, right? So here what is the case here? Suppose V in, for example, it is 2 volts I am taking and this is some plus 5 and this is some minus 5. That means 10 volts peak to peak of input signal we are taking. V in is 10 volts peak to peak we are taking. So that's there. We have a positive peak is plus 5 and negative peak is minus 5. And I am, for example, I am taking the reference value is plus 2 volts, right? So this is 0, right? 0 to 2 volts, what is the condition here? 0 to 2 volts. So if the input is 0 to 2 volts, reference value is greater, right? So that means V in is lesser than the V reference. So this is the case we have. V in is lesser than the V reference. So what is your output? That case. So here V in is smaller. V in is smaller. This period. This all the periods, the V in is smaller. So that means what is your output state will be a plus V sat. So starting below this value, up to this point, output will be in a plus V sat. So this is your plus V sat. Below these all the values, output should be a plus V sat. And greater values, upper values, it will be a larger, right? So this will be a greater than value, right? So above point, where it will be cutting, this up to this period again, it will be a greater value. So V in is greater. So V in is greater than this condition we have. V in is greater than the V reference. Output should be a minus V sat. So now output will be changes to a minus V sat. So up to which period? Up to again here there is a comparison point. So up to this interval of period, this value will be a again lesser, right? So V in is less. So your output should be in a minus V sat. Sorry. So up to this period, sorry. Up to this period it will be a minus V sat. Okay, up to this period it will be a greater, V in is greater. Now again it will be a V in lesser, so it will be changes to again plus V sat. Again here this point it will be having the comparison point. So V in again changes to greater value again. So as a greater output should be a plus V sat. Plus V sat will be changing to the minus V sat. If V in is greater, output should be a plus V sat. V in is greater, output should be a minus V sat. So like that, again after this point, again V in is greater. So as V in is greater, this will be having minus V sat. Again it will be a changing, that part will be changes to minus V sat. Okay, so after this interval of period, it will be a minus V sat. After this period of interval, it will be minus V sat. So like that, that output will be a change. So which waveform we are getting as output here? So input is a sinusoidal signal we are applied, but the output will be changes to a square waveform. So this comparator is applicable for a converting the square waveform. So whatever the wave shape we have, the input waveform, not only the sine, we may apply the triangular, any non-square waveform we may apply, but the output will be changes to the square. So that's why this comparator is generates the output as a square waveform. Whatever may be the input waveform, that output should be a square waveform. So that's why it is also called as a square wave converter. The comparator output is a square. Why it will be a square? The output will be changing between the two levels. That may be a plus V sat level and minus V sat level. So you have only two discrete levels, high level and low level. Output will be a digital. So that means a digital waveform, that square waveform will be generated. But in here, this may be a symmetrical square or asymmetrical square. You know the difference between the symmetrical and asymmetrical square waveform. Symmetrical square in the sense on period and off period will be the same. But here there will be a plus V sat. Again below values it will be a minus V sat, and again here plus V sat. So like that we are getting a symmetrical square period. So high level period on period and low level period off period. So this on period and off period must be equal, then that therefore is called a symmetrical square period. If V reference we made as zero, then the comparator output will be generated as symmetrical square period. If V reference is plus value or a minus value, some value it may take fixed value, that will be generated as asymmetrical square period. So that's the comparator working. And what is the applications here? It is will be used in a zero crossing detector, window detector.